Okay, is that working? Yes, we're recording. Okay. Hi, we're here tonight just to give you a little quick introduction to doTERRA Essential Oils. My name's Ebony Cheyne, and we're here with Laura Swan. And we're here to talk about the basic uses of essential oils. Just to give you a really quick head start, these are all big topics that we could probably talk about for hours. But we just want to give you a quick sort of insight into what essential oils actually are, about like the quality for shopping around for essential oils, what to look for, how they work with the body, different ways to use them. These are quite exceptional essential oils. You'll be able to use them in ways that other essential oils cannot be used. And of course, then we'll just talk about you know, practical ways to use these oils. So for me, I hadn't used essential oils extensively, like growing up and things like that. I was used to conventional medicine. And I had some health issues on my own, hormone imbalances, digestive issues when I was older, all different things sort of coming into play. And I was on a lot of medications and I went down the conventional route. And actually it was a doctor who got me into essential oils because I really just needed to really detoxify my life as much as possible. I mean, obviously environmental threats are out there and, you know, a lot of us work with chemicals and things, but at home it's really nice to kind of really detoxify as much as possible and make that a really nice zone that just really supports your body in all different ways. A lot of the chemicals we bring into our homes can cause imbalances in our body in different ways. So without going into that too much, that's what was really, really important to me. And that's why using the essential oils in all the different ways possible to their maximum effect was hugely important. And the quality of these oils is just so far and above anything I'd ever tried before. They had such an immediate effect for me. Like my body reacted very, very quickly. So I knew that they worked and I really dived in and I've never, ever looked back. I absolutely love them and I use them for everything. So we'll dive in just now. Laura's going to start talking about what essential oils actually are. So thank you, Laura.
Thanks, Ebony. So so I'm Laura Swan and I have been using essential oils all my life. We were kind of, my mum quite often went towards essential oils whenever we had anything that was going on. But it was just a few years ago that Ebony introduced me to doTERRA essential oils. And I was pregnant with my second little boy at the time. And I have to say, I was pretty blown away. I was really cynical, if I'm honest, when Ebony first handed me the bottle of lavender. I actually have my lavender here. And because I thought, how different can they honestly be from the oils that I'm already using? But when I first smelt the doTERRA lavender, it was that oil that just really blew my mind. It was like standing in a French lavender field. It was incredible. So pure, really, there was a real potency to it, but also it smelled like a herby lavender, like actual lavender smells, rather than some of the synthetic fragrances that I think I had been using in the past. So what are essential oils? Basically, they are pure liquid extracts that have been derived from a plant, and that can be from the flower, it can be even from the twigs, the leaves, the roots, the fruit of a plant, and they're either steam distilled or cold pressed. So all of the citrus oils are cold pressed, so that's when it's actually, the oils come from the peel of the fruit. So when you open a bottle of our lemon essential oil, you'll really, really get that sense from that oil. It's so zesty, the aroma really hits you. And that is because it's just like if you were to zest a lemon or peel a lemon skin, and that residue that you have on your hand, that is actually what you're getting some of the essential oil there. So they're not like a greasy oil. They'll absorb very quickly into your skin, but they're effectively chemical compounds from the plants themselves, so naturally derived. So these compounds have therapeutic properties. So it's very important, obviously, in aromatherapy, the smell will have an impact on you. And the smell is one of the biggest things that has an impact on our emotional memory. But actually what we're looking for is not just the smell of the oil, it's that they hit the right therapeutic benefits in terms of what that oil can do for us in our body. So for example, a lavender, we are expecting high quality lavender to be able to provide feelings of relaxation, to calm down the nervous system, to sort of sedate us, really, so that it brings everything down. And we're looking for very specific notes that make sure that that oil will deliver those therapeutic benefits. So they support our health and well-being very naturally, and they can soothe many different ailments and concerns. And doTERRA essential oils are 100% plant-derived, and they have nothing in them. So there's no additives, there's no preservatives, there are certainly no synthetics and no fillers either. What you're getting is 100% what we say is in the bottle. So this lavender is pure lavender oil. Now, a few reasons that we love essential oils is they are a natural alternative to chemical products. So as Ebony suggested, trying to reduce our toxic load, making sure that that we are not bombarding our system with toxic products. They're a beautiful way to reduce inflammation in the body and really support that. But also they're just a very simple solution for supporting our health within our own home. So for me, I have two little boys. I use them every single day with my entire family, and I personally have found them incredibly beneficial, both on an emotional and mental well-being perspective, but also supporting my physical health as well. But one thing that I do want to caution here is that quality is everything when it comes to your essential oils, and they are very, very potent. So just one drop of peppermint essential oil is equivalent to 28 cups of peppermint tea. So little and often, you only need one drop at a time, and that is the key. And again, the quality is something that you really, really want to be looking for when choosing your essential oils. So Ebony's going to talk a little bit about how we ensure quality in our oils.
Yeah, so as Laura was talking about, quality is so, so, so imperative. For me, when I was looking at essential oils, I was looking to really transform my health. So this was essential. And I did really want to make a difference. Like, it wasn't just so that I had a nice smelling bathroom, you know, at home. This was like, I really wanted to make a difference. So it is really, really, really important. And it becomes really important, really, in obvious ways. Like, when you buy essential oil normally from most places, it will actually say not to use it internally. And we'll talk about the different ways you can use essential oils, doTERRA essential oils, in a moment. But that's the reason that doTERRA take it so seriously. It's because, you know, literally, you know, this is plant extract. That's all it is. It's the compounds in the plant that are the immune system of the plant withdrawn, and then we're using it. There's no reason why we shouldn't be able to take that internally. And we do in many other forms. We, you know, grate the rind into our food. It's just that this is so, so concentrated. The only reason that we can't use most essential oils internally is because it's not essential oil in the bottles. You know, it's either synthetic forms, or it's diluted with something, or it's been tampered with in some way along that process of coming from Somalia on the edge of a cliff top, you know, or wherever it is that that particular oil has been sourced from. There's a whole world of things that gets in the way of getting the oil. And if you even compare it to something simple like wine, it's a really nice sort of simple way to understand that, you know, where you grow the plant and the conditions the plant grows in is exceptionally important to the product that you get from it. You know, wine does not taste the same when it's grown in Scotland as to when it's grown in the south of France, unfortunately for us in Scotland. So, you know, it's just one of those things that it really does make a difference. It makes a difference when the plant's harvested. And the plant could smell amazing at this particular time that it's harvested, but if the compounds aren't there, doTERRA are not going to harvest it and sell it in that bottle. So then they go into, not only do they take care of the whole process and how they go around sourcing it, they work with 140 countries worldwide to get the best compounds out there of all these different oils. They're always on the search. It's an incredible science-based company. But they also then do a ton of testing. So not only is like, it's not just like some companies where things are batch tests. This is like every single bottle of oil comes from test batches of oils from doTERRA labs. So, and it goes through like six different rounds of testing. You think these oils have got to go through all these different countries and all these different processes. There are so many places where, you know, things could happen to compromise the quality of the oil in the bottle. So doTERRA really actually put it through third party testing and six different testing systems until it gets into your hands. So yeah, we're really passionate about the quality of the oil, because that's the reason that these oils actually have such an amazing effect with our bodies. And just safety is a big big conscious concern when we're using essential oils. So it's really, really important to us, doTERRA, and then Laura is going to give you a little bit of information about the three popular ways to use these oils. Thank you.
So yeah, so as Ebony said, you know, we go through very, very rigorous testing, and doTERRA really are raising the standard of essential oils, and that is one of their absolute mission statements. They really want to ensure that essential oils are actually safer to use, you know, more in a more mainstream way. So the ways that we can use oils are, there's three different ways with doTERRA oils. Now, not all of the oils can be used in all three of these ways, but you can always find out by looking on the bottle, or checking with whoever is your wellness advocate that introduced you to the oils. So first things first, you can breathe them in. So I'm going to just demonstrate this with your with my lavender oil that I've got here. And so literally even just running underneath your nose, that is a way that you are going to experience the oil aromatically. Now, either inhaling deeply from a bottle, or you can use something like this. This is a diffuser. And what you're looking for in a diffuser is a humidifying diffuser. So you're looking for a cold water chamber. It doesn't heat the oils, so it doesn't adulterate the oils and the properties in that, but it will mist the room. So then you'll have airborne particles, and you will continue to breathe them in over a few hours period. And it's a really lovely way to not only scent your environment, but also to boost the whole family's or your workplace's health and well-being. So the reasons that you would use oils aromatically would be to calm any kind of emotional upset, perhaps boosting mood and energy. Peppermint and wild orange are excellent for that. The mid-afternoon slump. I always have a mid-morning slump as well, so I kind of like to do that both those points. It's also really good for any respiratory stuff that you've got going on. So if you've got any congestion or anything like that, it's lovely. It's a really gentle way as well to support the airways with aromatically. So it also, diffusing essential oils will kill airborne pathogens. So if you've got any kind of like colds and flus going on, any sickness in the house, or again in the workplace, it can quite often be, and it's a really nice way to purify the air that you're breathing. And it's also a lovely way to create a beautiful environment for sleep and rest as well. So that's how we would use the oil aromatically. Now moving on to topically, so you can literally, many of the oils for doTERRA, you can use neat. So again, you would just check the bottle whether or not it says to dilute it or not. But again, because they have been so rigorously tested, many of the oils that actually you might not have wanted to use undiluted in the past, you can with doTERRA. So it's just, again, checking. I like to personally dilute because it just means that my oils go further. It's more economical that way. And also, I would always, always dilute with children as well. So I've got my two little boys, and we always just make sure that our oils are diluted with them. And that would be in something like a roller bottle like this. So you would just put a couple of drops and top it up, and then you can roll it on them. But topically, with my lavender, this is just such a divine oil. You just get one drop in your palm of your hand. And when you're using your essential oils like this, you want to try and keep your fingertips away, because it's like cutting a chili. You will probably end up with it in your eye. If that does happen, do not panic. Just use a carrier oil, like even an olive oil or a sunflower oil or a coconut oil, to just wash it away. But basically what we do is we just rub the palms together, and then we can again have an aromatic experience breathing it in. But we can also just pop it on the back of our neck, our pulse points here as well, or on the bottoms of the feet. And that's a beautiful place to actually apply your essential oils topically, because the bottoms of the feet, the skin is less sensitive. So it's quite a nice way to patch test an oil to see if you might have a reaction to it. Generally speaking, the doTERRA essential oils are really, really lovely and gentle. You would make sure that you just pop it on the bottoms of your feet, and then that just soaks into the system as well. So it will really start to have an impact on your entire body. So topically, you can also obviously use it in a massage. You would just pop a drop or two in some carrier oil, and you can apply that to your body or to wherever you're maybe feeling an area of concern that you want to apply the oil to. So that's going to really work well to kind of soothe any tired or overworked muscles. It's going to be great for any joint discomfort that you have if you're applying the oils topically. It can be very good for calming skin irritation as well. So lavender is a beautifully soothing oil. It's actually very good for any cuts or scrapes or burns. It's basically like a little first aid kit in a bottle. Brilliant for around kids. But especially even if you have like burns from using hair tongs or anything like that, it's a great oil to have on hand. But also using your oils on your body will really help to support your immune system, because they're going to soak into your system and start to work with your body to ensure that you are in a healthy state. So the last way that you can use oils is internally. So we only recommend this with some of the doTERRA oils, not all of them. But what that's going to do, you can just pop one drop into a glass of water. Now, if you're ever taking essential oils internally or like mixing them into water or a warm water, you would use a glass or ceramic or stainless steel and not a plastic bottle. It's just because essential oils have a bit of an ability to leach the toxins. So they actually, in a plastic bottle, they're not good to be used in that. So you would just use a glass bottle or a ceramic bottle, ceramic cup, or a stainless steel bottle as well for that. And you can also use them. We have these things called veggie caps. So it's like an empty capsule and you can actually pop some drops in that. So the oils that you might want to use internally would be, for example, your lemon oil. So some of you may drink lemon squeezed, like lemon juice in your water already. And that is a beautiful way to really alkalize the system and cleanse out that system in the morning and kickstart everything to get it going. But actually lemon oil, just a drop of lemon oil, will have exactly those same benefits, with the added benefit that there's not the acidity of the fruit, so it doesn't actually attack your teeth enamel. So the lemon or wild orange or grapefruit, they're beautifully cleansing oils and they'll alkalize the body. Grapefruit as well helps to kickstart the metabolism, but it also suppresses appetite. So that's a great oil if you're trying to kind of manage cravings or that sort of thing. And then another oil that you might want to be using internally would be your peppermint oil to look at your digestion. So these are ways that we can be using those essential oils internally. And particularly if you're facing any kind of actual ailments, so for example, like cold and flu, taking a capsule internally of, say, for example, oregano will really get to the source quite quickly. And that's, again, when you would want to be looking at taking oils internally. So that's the three ways, aromatically, topically, and internally, that you can use the doTERRA essential oils. So, yeah, Ebony, how do they work on the system? I think you're going to chat us a bit about that.
Thanks, Laura. Okay, so yeah, we just wanted to kind of cover as well why they actually work with the body and how they actually work with the body. And this is where, you know, doTERRA really is changing the game with essential oils, as Laura is talking about. Because we're using essential oils, like even if you're using them aromatically, like some people don't want to use essential oils internally because they've been taught that, you know, other essential oils shouldn't be used internally, and that's perfectly fine. But the truth is that whenever you're using any products or any essential oils in the air, you are using them internally because your body takes in everything in the environment. So like, you know, if you think of your skin as more of like a sponge rather than a barrier, you know, everything you're putting on there is going into your system and is filtrating through your body and everything and having to be cleaned out by your liver and everything like that. So, you know, everything in your environment is being used internally. For doTERRA, this quality thing is just, it's so, so, so important. The essential oils have the ability to, like when Laura was saying, you can use them topically, you can put them on the bottom of your feet. They actually, you know, go through your body within seconds. So if you put some diluted peppermint on a child's foot, you can taste it on the dummy within seconds. You know, like, so if I'm putting on lots of oils in my body, I can taste them in my mouth, or if I put them on my face, I can taste them instantly almost, a lot of the oils. So they really do systemically go through your body really, really fast, and plus they work together as well, so they enhance each other's benefits, which is a really cool thing. You start to have more than one and you can start to mix and match. And also why doTERRA makes so many amazing blends already, gives you a head start there. But really with the body, what happens is they're actually like they're going inside the cell. So with most, you know, when you're using synthetic medicine and like your usual sort of go-to things, they're really just masking the symptoms because they're working from outside the cells in the body. So they're maybe hiding like switching off the part of your brain of recognizing the pain, but they're not actually making the symptom any better, right? It's still going on inside. It's just you're not recognizing the discomfort. With essential oils, it's totally different. They're really working with your body to get rid of the symptom or get rid of the issue and just create balance back in your body. So it's not about hiding the problem or sort of masking the problem. It's about supporting your body not to really have the problem in the first place, whether that's in terms of prevention or in terms of when you have stuff come up. So yeah, the really cool thing about them is because they are oil, and I'm certainly no biologist, but you know, cellular membranes are, you know, oil-based, the essential oils can actually penetrate that cell membrane and get inside the cells. And that's why something like if you have like a virus or something like that, they work from inside the cell and speed that virus up and push it out. And that's really much more beneficial than sort of knocking you out. And then that virus is stuck in your body for a long, long time. You really just want to get that out. And it's the same kind of thing as all these old wives' tales with all the herbs, but it's a lot easier. It's a lot more pleasant. It's a lot faster, more powerful than putting like onions in your socks or, you know, overusing garlic. So much more beneficial to get that kind of effect. So I hope that kind of makes sense and it gives you an overall idea as to all, I mean, there's so many different ways to use these oils. They are super versatile. And yeah, you'll hopefully learn more about the individual oils as we go along. But yeah, this is just a short introduction and please feel free to put any questions underneath. Laura, do you have anything else to add?
No, I think that's everything. So it is a quick introduction and, you know, obviously there's things like dilution charts that we can provide for you and safety guidelines. But really, you know, one of the things I would say is just use them, just enjoy them, you know, and see how oils make these oils make you feel, you know. And you can always, as Ebony said, like always ask us questions along the way. So
yeah, maybe we should just say a few of actually some really great resources that we also have as well. So there's things like there's doTERRA.com is amazing. They have loads of information on there. SourceToYou.com is a great website all about doTERRA sourcing and everything like that. There's PubMed. PubMed is a great resource for loads of science studies about essential oils and all different kinds of stuff like that. And then there's all kinds of books that we use and apps and things like that for more specific things. When we go into more about different oils, there are much more, obviously there's going to be sort of like your common complaints and then there's going to be more specific things you want to know about. So there's definitely loads of resources you can go to for all that kind of information you can share with you. But I think that's really it for the intro.
Great. Well, hopefully we've covered it all for now.
Just a quick, you hope you feel comfortable opening your bottles and using them. That's the purpose.
Absolutely.
All right. Well, thank you for listening.
Thanks so much. It's such a pleasure to be here with you. And yeah, looking forward to sharing more about oils with you all.
Thanks so much, Laura, for being here too. Thank you. Thanks everyone for watching. Enjoy your oils.